each of you for coming tonight on Friday night to spend some time in worship and preparing our hearts and our minds and our sanctuary for the Advent season. If you'll please stand as you're able, we'll begin our time together with a call to worship as printed in your bulletin. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Christ has come. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
This is the faith of the Church of Jesus Christ.
When we look at the world around us, we see the darkness of war, captivity, greed, and broken relationships. The word of the gospel is that Jesus Christ lives among us, bringing truth and light as a present reality.
We worship as those who have glimpses of that reality, and we are its fullness. We are those who labor to make Christ's life more visible on earth.
Long for the simple beauty of Christmas, for all the old familiar melodies, words, and symbols that remind us of that great miracle when He who had made all things came one night as a babe to lie in the crook of a woman's arm. But in that longing, let us even more yearn for your renewed presence among us, even as we celebrate and expect the coming of your Son. We bring you our gratitude for every token of your love, for all the ways you heaped blessings upon us during the year that has gone by. And we do pray, Lord, that as we begin this four-week journey of expectation and hope, we may do it in a manner well-pleasing to you. May all we do and say, every tribute of our hearts bring honor to your name, that we, your people, may remember your birth and feel your presence among us. Amen.
We begin the Christian year by celebrating the holy season known as Advent. It is a time when we prepare ourselves for the coming of our Messiah. Advent means coming. We celebrate these days of Advent in expectation and preparation for Christ's arrival. Through the centuries, Christians have observed a time of waiting and expectation before celebrating the birth of the Savior at Christmas. The Advent season is a time for reflection and preparation, but its mood is joyful. Advent has been enriched by Christian tradition to reflect its distinctive Christian meaning. It proclaims the revelation of God's love as expressed in Christ's birth in a humble stable, his sacrificial death on the cross, and his victorious resurrection. It points to the hope of Christ coming again as the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Advent makes innkeepers out of all of us, asking each of us to make room for the arrival of Christ the King. Let us today prepare him room in our hearts, our lives, and our homes.
Our hymn to be done now is on page 200. Thank you. month, ancient Romans, evergreens were embellished with of peace, joy, and victory. The early Christians placed them on their windows to indicate that Christ had entered the home. Holly and ivy, along with pine and fir, are called evergreens because they never change color. They are evergreen, ever alive, even in the midst of winter. They symbolize the unchanging nature of our God, and they remind us of the everlasting life that is ours through Jesus Christ. Under Christian thought and sentiment, holly became widely used in church celebrations. Holly was considered as a burning bush, or a symbol of Mary, whose very being glows with the Holy Spirit. The red berries represent the blood drops from the cruel thorns in the crown of Jesus. In Isaiah 60:13, we find these words: "The glory of Lebanon shall come unto you, the fir tree, the pine tree, and the box together to beautify the place of your sanctuary." Today, the Christmas tree is the center of our festivities, glittering with lights and ornaments. It is a part of the beauty and meaning of Christmas. There are several links and stories behind the Christmas tree. The first use of the Christmas tree was in medieval German paradise plays held outdoors, portraying the creation of humankind. The tree of life was a fir tree decorated with apples. Later, other ornaments were hung upon them, such as paper, flower, and gilded nuts. In England, branches or whole trees were forced into bloom indoors for Christmas. From these beginnings, the use of a tree at Christmas were established. Martin Luther was perhaps the first to use a lighting tree. The story is told that on Christmas Eve, Martin Luther wandered outdoors and became enraptured with the beauty of the starry sky. Its brilliance and loveliness led him to reflect on the glory of the first Christmas Eve, as seen in Bethlehem's radiant skies. Wishing to share with his wife and children the enchantment he had felt, he cut from the forest an evergreen, glistening with snow, and took it home. He placed upon it candles to represent the glorious heavens he had seen, using the candlelight tree spread all across Europe. Then America came to regard it as a central ornament of Christmas.
Thank you.
in Mexico. Maria and her little brother were very poor. They loved Christmas, but were always sad because they had no money to buy presents. They especially wished that they could give something to the church for the baby Jesus, but they had nothing. One Christmas Eve, Maria and Pablo set out to attend the service. On their way there, they picked some weeds growing along the roadside and decided to take them as their gift to baby Jesus in the manger scene. Of course, the other children teased them when they arrived with their gift, but they said nothing, for they knew that they had given what they could. Maria and Pablo began placing the green plants around the manger, and miraculously, the green top leaves turned into bright red petals, and soon the manger was surrounded with by beautiful star-like flowers, and so we see them today.
The use of colors to differentiate liturgical seasons became a common practice in the Western Church in about the 4th century. The colors express emotions and ideas that are associated with each of the seasons of the liturgical year. Purple is normally Advent's liturgical color, associated with the sovereignty of Christ, our King of Kings.
Verses 1, 3, and 4. ages testifies of the continuation of life and life without end. The four candles encircle the Christ candle to signify God's Son as the light of the world. The four candles represent the 4 weeks in Advent. Each Sunday, we will light a candle, and on Christmas Eve, the Christ candle will be lit. With increasing brightness from the candles, we experience the light of the world and find hope in the coming Christ.
St. Francis of Assisi created the very first nativity scene in 1223 in an effort to promote the true meaning of Christmas. The idea caught on, and soon a new Christmas tradition was born. Today, it's almost impossible for one to go through the Christmas season without seeing a nativity scene in front of a church, in a Christmas play, decorating someone's yard, or placed in a place of prominence in a worship setting. day of the Lord is coming soon. The signs have been fulfilled. Lest that day comes and finds us unaware, let us confess our sins to God our Father, asking his forgiveness for the sake of Jesus Christ, who will soon come as judge and king. Most merciful God, we long for your coming, O God, but we are often unprepared for you to come, because we have not always lived as your people. Many times in our lives we have disobeyed your will. We have not always done what we should have done. Sometimes we have done what we should not have done. Sometimes we have failed to do what we should. We ask your forgiveness and seek the power of your Holy Spirit to restore our faith. He who is coming has come, born among us to live our life and die our death and guarantee our resurrection. For his sake, I proclaim to you forgiveness of sin and transformation through Jesus Christ. The gifts of the Lord are yours in great abundance. Come, Lord Jesus, come. Amen. People say that a name is everything. Products are named to make everybody want to try them. Books are named to entice people to read them. A name with a good reputation communicates trustworthiness and quality. So what is God's child to be named? The name is Emmanuel, God with us. It's a name that comforts in times of need and stress, strengthens in times of challenge and decision, and encourages in moments of weakness and doubt. God with us, continually, infinitely. Amen.
Thank you.
blessing and benediction. Now may the God who has called us to live in hope and expectation go with you as you journey in faith toward that new future created by God's love that has dwelt and continues to dwell among us. Go in God's grace and in his peace. Amen.